Hello everyone. In previous video lecture, we discussed about the meaning of expression process. Today's video lecture we start the classifications of expression process. The mainly the direction of the expression process, you have two types: direct expression process and indirect expression process. Direct expression process is also called as the forward expression process. First of all, see the what is meant by a direct expression process. So it is a process in which the metal billet is in hot metal placed in a cylindrical container that is forced by a plunger or ram to pass through a die, then we get the desired object. In this type, the direction of flow of metal is in same as that of movement of ram. So whatever give the direction to the flow of metal, it is same to the that ram movement. The punch closely fits the die cavity to prevent backward flow of the material. If you see the figure, the heated billet is placed in the that we call as the container, having a die holes, a ram compressed the material forcing it to flow through the die holes. When the force applied from the ram to the billet, a billet moves. When it passing through the die, its cross sectional area reduced, then we get the extruded products. Here dies are fixed to the container only. See, the direction of forcing ram or container, the same the direction of a material coming outside from the die. If you see in the cross sectional figure, this is pressing ram. Here we have the additional dummy block. Front of that we have the billet and the container surrounding the billet, and the dies are connected to the this container, and for supporting dies we have the die backer. When the force is applied to the billet, the extrusion to pull the material from the die, then we get the desired product of the component. The cross sectional area of the billet is reduced to required size and shape. During direct extrusion, metal flow and forces required are affected by the friction between the workpiece and the container walls. Particularly in hot forming at higher temperatures, for this reason, it is common manufacturing practice to place a dummy block ahead of the ram. The dummy block is of slightly smaller diameter than the chamber and workpiece. As the extrusion proceeds, the almost surface of the work is not extruded and remains in the chamber. This material will form a thin shell that is called as the skull, which can be removed later by the suitable process. The major disadvantage of this process is due to the large force requirement for extrusion. For pulling also, if a force is required, and for the pressing also, the force is required. Since the billet has to travel through the entire length of the container, The frictional forces between the work metal and the container wall resist the work movement, and hence large force is required to overcome friction and deformations. The direct extrusion finds application in the manufacture of solid rods, bars, hollow tubes, that is hollow circular tubes or hollow square blocks, according to the design and shape of the dies. This is all about the direct extrusion. Next we see indirect extrusion process. It is also called as the backward extrusion process. First we see what is mean by indirect extrusion process. It is a process in which a hollow ram containing the die is forced into the container containing the metal. The indirect extrusion also called as the net backward extrusion process, because a type of extrusion process wherein the work metal flows in the direction opposite to the ram movement of the net metal flow. In this type, the die is mounted to the ram and not on the container. This is most important. Where in direct extrusion process, die is mounted to the container only, but here the die is mounted to the ram, it is movable one. As the ram compresses, the metal flows through the die hole on the ram side, which is in opposite direction to the movement of ram. If you see in the figure, you can clearly understand. The surrounding are the cylindrical container. Inside you have to place the work billet. See, the ram is applying the force to the this billet, then the extruded metal's direction also same here. Clear? So it is mentioned that the metal flow in the direction opposite to the ram movement. The forcing the ram is the one direction, and the extruded metal comes outside is the another direction. So directions are opposite to each other. Direct extrusion, the billet remains stationary while the die is pushed into the billet by a hollow ram through which extrusion takes place. The billet and container do not experience any displacement, and hence there is no frictional forces between the work and the container. What about in direct extrusion process? The frictional forces are occurred between the container and work billet. Thus, the force required for extrusion is less than that required for direct extrusion. For the certain limitations, as a tooling and machining setup are more complicated compared to the direct extrusion process. A hollow rams are not strong and rigid, and also the support of the length of the extruded product in the hollow ram is difficult. For all of understood the meaning of direct or indirect extrusion process. Thank you.